Hello, my Sock Universe. Back from vacation, back at review videos, and I decided now to go only for Austria in this video, and I will do a Germany video as well for just this week because we have 3 weeks in Austria to cover. So, and I don't want to make the videos all too long. As I said, this season I want to try to make the videos a little bit shorter, but for future weeks I will keep Germany and Austria together again. Okay, don't be fooled by me wearing Lusk and having all my Lusk jerseys, almost all my Lusk jerseys up there, as one missing. It is because that's the only Austrian team that I have. In fact, I have to say the start to the season for Lusk is rather tough and rather unsatisfying. And the fact is that in 3 weeks I cannot talk about a single win. All the wins were in the Europa League. But I can't talk about a single win in the league now, although I would argue there should have been at least one. I think the overall balance sheet should look a whole lot better. But then I also have to say at least we are not a Rapid who find themselves in some early trouble, which I think is also a little bit overreaction. We're still early in the season, everything gets going, and while I hate to use it as an excuse, it has to be said that especially Rapid and Lusk, and now it will become Sturm, those teams have been playing in Europe, so they have this ridden Thursday, Sunday, which is not a good ridden because you have a lot of time to prepare for Europe, where you can maybe get the rest, and then you have to quick turn around play in the league, which might make it a little bit harder. But then again, all these teams wanna do that. And so I think no one really is using this as an excuse for, maybe I heard it a little bit with Rapid, but it was more kind of an annoying question by the by the reporter. I have to say Rapid is getting better there because they have always been complaining that they're playing way too many games. So I'm gonna run through a few remarkable games that we had. And then I'll show you the final table, and at the very end you see the overall development. I will put it like that. We have to talk about a game where I was actually stuck in a traffic jam, so I could at least gauge a whole lot more than I would have if I would have been driving to the airport, which was Lusk against Rapid. Probably the marquee fixture in all of these rounds so far. And Rapid had a really tough game in Prague with, diminished squad through to injuries, COVID and so on, and had a tough game there, and I think Lusk was just waiting for that to destroy them. However, individual errors at the moment, the thing that undo Lusk, and very early on Funtas could score for Rapid, and Lusk was not showing up, and that was really a problem for the first half. Second half, completely different big picture. Lusk started to gain control, had them more or less where they wanted, just couldn't convert. Finally, they got the chance, but at that point, Rapid had actually already hit the bar, as far as I remember. Then Lusk had a lot of possession, but not really big chances. But then Alexander Schmidt makes it 1-1. At that point, then you really thought that the game will tip. There was a big chance for Rapid at the end to win it, but the biggest controversy is that for the first time VAR, or the assisted referee have said didn't use VAR to get the correct decision, because Karamoko was brought down in the 94th minute in the box. It was a clear foul, and even the Rapid defender Arazi said, yeah, I was lucky there. The way it went was, of course, that the referee said he saw the contact and he evaluated it, said it's not a penalty. The VAR said, maybe you want to have a look at it. No, I saw it, I don't need it. A huge controversy, because if Lusk gets the penalty and converts it, which is not a given, I think we will talk a whole different game or season so far. At the same time, Admira got a huge win. Has been ages that Admira won before. It looks very impressive. However, Klagenfurt had 2 players sent off before Admira scored any goals. Don't want to devalue Admira as a win, but you know, if you play, and I think all those red cards came relatively early in the game. So in the end, it was then a 4-0 win. Austria win, very lucky, 1-1. Sturm came then roaring back with a 4-1 over Wolfsburg. after their home loss to Salzburg. And at that point, you kind of knew, yeah, Wolfsburg might be in for a tough season, where Sturm Graz, yeah, they played the first game against Salzburg, but that is a team to watch out for. And that Salzburg is just in a class of their own, 7-1 against Ried and Adeyemi, scoring at least three and still being the outstanding player of the league. Then a week later, in probably one of the most remarkable games of the season between Austria Klagenfurt and Hartberg, it was remarkable for the Georgian match, because how often do you see pink, purple against pink? It was, yeah, I don't want to say pink, because pink like a rose tone for Hartberg. So that was remarkable. I think it was a game that went back and forth. Klagenfurt, I think, had even 4-1, if not 4-1 or 4-4, they really looked cruising, but Hartberg came back, and in a stoppage time, they missed a penalty. So it could have well ended 4-4. Sturm Graz continued the good form with 3-1 win. Rapid, also again Funtos, who scored, the only player who scores for Rapid at the moment, scored a hat-trick to beat Wolfsburg, and you could already say Wolfsburg is really in for a tough time. Despite new coach Robin Dutt, they either need to get used, you see that a completely revamp. Tirol LASK, similar story as for the Rapid game, except that Tirol was even more dominant in the first half. LASK has a really hard time getting a game going. They found themselves very well deserved 1-0 down. Shortly after the half, they could get an equalizer, but then the game was kind of balanced. Maybe 1-1, yes. If you play like that, like you play in the second half, you probably could win, but this was a team that we still cannot beat, and that's just annoying. And Salzburg also, with a little bit of luck, deserve it, but it was also lucky. Late by Adeyemi beat Austria Wien 1-0. And then we come to the current round against Salzburg with a late win against Admira Wacker. And there was a whole lot more controversial because Admira had probably a good goal ruled out because of a supposed foul on the goalkeeper, which wasn't right there. Penalty, similar to the last penalty, denied late, and Salzburg also scoring. I mean, wasting match and hitting twice the post, and then getting the goal. But you know, that was a lot closer, and it was probably the toughest game that Salzburg faced against lowly Admira, and maybe Admira will be a team to watch this season. The big story, of course, was Rapid again losing. They were 1-0 up, had a wonderful goal by Funtos, actually. Did this out rightfully so by offside, but then Mark Grull with a free kick through the wall, opened up wide, made it 1-0, and Rapid thought they could play at home. No, they could not, absolutely not. Altach didn't show much, but in the last 10 minutes, Nussbaumer gets an equalizer, fractionally, not offside, and then a really stupid hands penalty, and Altach turns around, and there are storm clouds rising around Rapid already, because that's not the start of the season that you expect. You've already lost twice, only won once, so the turnaround didn't happen. And Austria, the duel of the Austrians ended with a 1-1. And then LASK against Sturm, I watched that game yesterday. It was a really tense and tight game, in quite some heat. And I have to say, the first 50 minutes clearly Sturm, then LASK was better, but couldn't finish the chances. Finishing is a big problem for LASK. I think Flecker hit the post late on. And then when you really thought, yeah, this might well end in a draw, which probably would have suited both quite well. I mean, the winner would have for sure taken second place, but I think a draw might not have been the worst result. Again, an individual error by Marasic, who had to come on, who already made a big error in the Rapid game, enabled Yeboah to get the 1-0 for Sturm. Then LASK was storming, get called out again on the count. It's 2-0. Right after that, Michael pulls from back. And when LASK was trying to move forward, Sturm scores a third, and they look to be set at the moment for the number two spot. So, as I said, Sturm probably will be a tough opponent this season, but it's very early, so no overreactions yet. At the current standing, Salzburg flying high, Sturm Graz with 9 points right behind there. And then we have two surprise teams, Ried, who have been beaten really badly by Salzburg, actually have otherwise a pretty good season so far. Altach also already with two wins, and then only you see Lask there, but still hanging relatively safe in the top spots. The two Vienna teams are down, and Wolfsburg seems to be in a whole lot of trouble, and I'm not sure how long Tut will last. As for the expected final regular season standings, you see that after Vienna, who was actually in the top six, now already fell out of the top six, whereas Tirol is in there, Wolfsburg just about hanging in there as well. And for the final standings, Sturm has a pretty good rating. They're now odds on to finish second at this very moment. Things still can turn around quite a lot. You see it's kind of tight for a second, third and fourth. And again, Austria Vienna might win the bottom group, but that's not good enough. So this is what was happening in Austria. The next round actually doesn't have the really outstanding game. Maybe Sturm against Austria is one that would be for a neutral watch. Of course, I want to watch Lask Hartberg. I might even go to the stadium. I have to think about that. Wolfsburg at Mira is also one of those where I don't really know what to expect. This could be a sleeper game there for sure. So yeah, that's where it stands all in Austria. I will leave you with all the statistics over the past few rounds there to see how things were developing. And yeah, I will talk to you soon, and I hope I can talk more and about better things for LASK happening in the Austrian Bundesliga. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, here are some videos and playlists that you actually might enjoy too. Also, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the little bell icon so that you get updated whenever something happens in my soccer universe. And with that, have a wonderful day.